Now, let us speak the truth here. Is this flower not beautiful? Thank you. Now, is it possible that someone may not like it? It's very true. Is it right for that person to say, I don't like that flower because it is ugly? Of course. And so up to that point, we agree that as much as this flower is this beautiful to me and probably you, someone else may not like it and has the right to share their opinion about it. Now, this is the genesis of quarrels and disagreements in many relationships. That you are right does not mean the other person is wrong. Both of you could be right. It's only that you have different definitions of right. And so if only you can come together and say to yourself, I know you could be right, I could be wrong, I could be wrong, you could be right. Let's therefore come together and agree on what can work for both of us. In so doing, you can bring peace in a lot of situations. Little arguments ferment to become a big war, simply because everyone is trying to prove they are right, not trying to prove what is right. So in the event of trying to defend ego, it ends up as a big quarrel, simply because everyone believes he or she is right. Another aspect of the same, that we are friends does not mean we also share enemies. Because you hate someone, you don't need to go around recruiting other people to hate the same person. People are different, including family members. You could be born by the same parents, but you don't share attitude, you don't share the brain. You are completely different. It is until we recognize that people are different and they have different likes and dislikes, we can always want to create people in our own image and likeness, which is like chasing mirage because it can never come to pass. Now, like I said, this flower is beautiful. If I change my mind and say that it's no more beautiful, that it is ugly, will the flower change its color and even its shape? Definitely no. And so who has changed here? I have changed. Why, therefore, do you bother so much what people say about you if whatever they say cannot change your reality? That someone said you are a fool does not make you one. That someone looked down on you and treated you like trash does not reduce you. Even if people change the way they treat you, don't conform to their nature. Maintain the good you no matter the circumstance. That is you. Let people not mold you the way they want, so that when they change and start acting evil, you also follow them in that channel. No, remain the same you. Like I said, I like this flower because it is very beautiful, and I can't fathom someone not liking it. I can't just figure it out. But do you know what? Someone hates it. Someone can pass it and we don't even turn its own neck. Let me tell you something. It is not wise to ever think that no one hates you. Some people will hate you just by looking at you. They've never seen you before, but they just hate you naturally. And you also do the same. Some people are close to you. They talk to you nicely. They are around you. They accolade you and all kinds of things, but inside their heart, they hate you. It is good for you to know such, so that when such people are tired of pretending around you and they start showing themselves, you won't be surprised. Truth be told, that is how life is. And that can make you live comfortable when you know the balance of life. People are different. We have different likes and dislikes. And coming together to agreement can bring harmony. The antagonism will only cause chaos in our relationships. Understand people. Stand behind them to see what they see. That will enhance your relationship with people. Thank you so much. This is Kelly, and kindly get my book on Seeing Beyond the Obvious on Amazon or you can contact the email and number below to get a copy delivered to you. Remember to subscribe, click the notification so you get the videos immediately we upload them. Thank you.